Hello, folks. This is Daryl Cagle. I'm streaming my process of drawing today's cartoon. Look forward to chatting with anybody that wants to come online. Still waiting just a second for YouTube to start up. We're live on Twitch now. So we'll start in just a minute. Okay, hello folks on YouTube. We don't have anybody watching yet, but we're just getting started. Today I'm going to draw my daily editorial cartoon. It's going to be a foot with this little piggy, which is a cartoon I drew about 10 years ago on another topic. But looks like a good one to bring back since it's been 10 years since I drew it, and it's kind of a editorial cartooning standard to draw this little piggy went to market cartoon, so that is what this one will be. And welcome everyone. So please hop up and chat and have something to say. This is my rough note to myself about what today's cartoon is going to be. And oh, that's my mouse. Mouse on the tabletop. Okay. This is going to be a wordy cartoon and a kind of a strange cartoon. And I usually shy away from doing the wordy cartoons, but I'm going to do it today. So part of what I'm going to be doing is figuring out just what the words are that I want in here, because I didn't spend a whole lot of thought on that note to myself about how to do this. So the layout will be thus, and I'm going to have a foot with piggies, two, three, four good looking piggies. Toenails there that I'm pleased with. He could have a bunion. These are the Republican presidential candidate piggies. That's an unusually fat piggy because it's Chris Christie. And here's a little Bush piggy. This second toe is always interesting on feet because sometimes it's longer than the big toe, and it's always the most interesting toe. If I can be happy with each of these, because this one will be Cruz. I'm not going to label these. This is just for my own personal edification. Ah, Scott, Eric, Cody, Florian, so nice to see you guys here. Well, I'm sorry you can't stay today, Florian. Nice to catch you here, Cody. So let's go with a little bit of hammer toes on everybody. Again, this is an editorial cartooning standard. It's kind of like drawing the Hokey Pokey or the theme from Gilligan's Island or Green Acres. It's something that comes up over and over, and that's okay. There's an old saying in editorial cartooning. If one other person drew it, you're a plagiarist. If two other people drew it, you're a hack. And if 5 other people drew it, you're following a great tradition. So this one is following a great tradition many times over. Big toe right, because the big toe is Trump. This toe is Rubio. This one is Rubio? Carson. I drew 6 toes in my sketch. I'm gonna kill Christie. That fat toe doesn't suit me. So Christie gets killed and he's going to become Carson. Little toe will be Jeb. Those are starting to look a little toesy, huh? Okay. Toenail detail in there. Yeah, Christy just got bumped to the second foot, and nobody watches the second foot. Gotta perform better in the polls to make it to the first foot. I'm gonna give him a little bit of hairy toes, too. A little bit of crud going on, a little bit of shadow. It's a nasty foot. Wordy cartoon today. Talk about lettering. It's interesting, I've drawn lots of not so wordy cartoons in a row. No lettering at all. Most editorial cartoonists are pretty wordy. They use lots of labels. These are not going to be labeled. You're just gonna have to know which toe each one is. And I don't think I'm quite facile enough to actually make the toes look like toe caricatures. There were some very disturbing movies that had talking toes and thumbs. I guess that works. I drew 6 toes in my sketch. That's kind of funny. With 11 candidates and only 10 toes, I don't know, you're screwed when you're doing candidate feet. So, folks, give me a comment. Nice to see you guys here. Isn't quite right. I'm gonna be a little smaller, a little longer and smaller. Use a little unclipped at the end. Okay. Now I need to lay out generally where these words are gonna fall. I'm going to have a word box here, the big toe, here, for the second toe. Here, for the third toe. Here, for, don't know what you call that toe. Here. Or mistletoe. And I'm going to have a little text box down there. Not looking right. Then I'll sign over here. I do figure this out as I do it. It's not in my head before it shows up on the page. And I should apologize to you too. Remember that my video is delayed by about a minute. So I see your comments right away, but you're not going to hear me respond for a minute. Cody Ford writes, I tried your process this morning from sketch to vellum to scan in Photoshop. Loved it. Do you sketch on vellum with a 4H pencil? I think you mentioned that before. Yeah, right now I'm sketching with a number 2 Dixon Conderoga office pencil on a piece of just whatever paper this is. Looks like 11 by 17. My vellum is 14 by 17. So I draw pretty big. Most editorial cartoonists draw small, and they think of drawing small as a time saver. And I don't see any reason why drawing small should save any time. That just seems kind of ridiculous. You're drawing the same lines. Large or small, shouldn't take any longer to draw them bigger. Okay, now over here, Donald Trump toe. This little piggy is huge. And leading in the holes. Up here for the Cruz toe. This little piggy was natural born in Canada. And this toe this young piggy doesn't manage his own money well. All right, six toe Carson. This sleepy piggy looks out of place with all the white toes. Over here, check this just a second. This Jeb piggy went wee wee to Florida. Then down here, I'm going to put something in Helvetica. So, how will these boxes move around? To myself as I do this. This one should probably be a little bit wider. Make that one point here. This one's a little wider. I can stretch an extra word into each line. This one should move over a little bit. Let's move that one that way. It could probably be a little wider too because I could make Jeb skinnier and up a little bit, just a skosh. That one points there, that one points there. Well, I'm glad you enjoyed the process, Cody. I think it's the only reasonable way to draw. People make so much more trouble for themselves than they really need to when they do this stuff. Okay, that was a quick sketch. Maybe I'm ready to go to Vellum already. I think I'm kind of cranking here. It's such an easy one. All right, let's do that. So the other day when I was doing this, I realized that my camera, that's right up here, was tilted out a little bit over my drawing table, pointing down in front of me. So you could see down my front and into my pants above the chair, which made me realize I really do need to be wearing pants while I do this. That would have been an online disaster had I not been wearing pants. And drawing without pants is something that is known to happen with cartoonists. Cody writes, I used to draw in blue pencil, scan, and digitally ink, but the spontaneous look was lost. Your technique keeps the lines fresh and lively. You know, I always thought that I loved looking at artists' rough sketches because the rough sketches always, for some reason, seem to look better than the inks that they spend so much time getting just right. Why not just go with the rough sketches that look better? Okay, am I ready to roll on this? I think I need to draw that outside thing last. The lettering first, then you do your boxes around the lettering. Okay. And I can also fix this in Photoshop. Oops, I made a mistake right away. Kind of a dyslexic cartoonist. I'm not sure I can talk while I'm doing lettering. It hasn't come up yet since I've been drawing these wordless cartoons. My head's too big. Fix that on the next one. It's Jeb Piggy. Thank you. not so much talking when I do lettering. I'm using the part of my brain that I use to talk. See, my dyslexia kicks in when I think about talking to Florida. This. Would you consider syndicating a cartoonist who is no longer associated with the newspaper? Yeah, I do that. It often leads to tears because having no home and nobody paying you other than syndication. Leads to some frustration. This sleepy piggy looks out of place. I think it's going to be a rhetorical question soon because there aren't very many people who are going to have jobs at newspapers with all the white toes. One way you spot a beginning cartoonist or a amateur cartoonist is they like to use computer fonts in their cartoons and often do not do it well. Works in comics, doesn't work so well in editorial cartoons or general illustration. This. So one first thing I advise people is throw away the computer fonts in your art. This young piggy. His own money well. Picking up some of these verticals that got a little light. Not a lot of comments here, folks. On camera dyslexia.
So, Cody Ford writes, I work in IT, but Cartoon Daily looking for an outlet. Originally was in print with the Galveston Daily many years ago, before personal computers. Galveston Daily, that sounds like a good one. No interest from them anymore. Intro born. Oh no, that's why I had it differently. Was natural born in Canada because he has renounced his Canadian citizenship. So he was natural born. In Canada. I'm going to leave that one for a while because I don't want to drag my hand through it. So. Let's go to drawing these boxes. Start this way. I'm going to give him a double box. Cody Ford writes, my cartoons taught many puppies to go the paper. Ah. Yeah, what are all these youngsters going to do with a puppy and bird and fish wrapping paper? So far, it looks like, with all this conflagration in publishing, that I think editorial cartoons are going to survive fine. It's already so hard to be an editorial cartoonist, and it pays so little. Perhaps we're numb to the pain settling on everyone else right now. Have a little bit of shade going on there. The sleepy piggy looks out of place with all the white toes. I have to remember when I'm coloring to make this a toe of color. Cody Ford writes, my first political cartoon earned me $10, but being in print was my goal. Well, you want to be a part of the national conversation, gotta have a place that you call your home in print, and a way of distributing the second rights to your cartoons to a larger audience that pays a pittance, which is really where you have your impact and participate in the national debate and where people see your cartoons. Maybe that's a nice website client that needs a little bit of exclusive content. Well, I shouldn't say exclusive. You want to sell your second rights. Otherwise, what's the point of drawing for less than you're worth for
somebody who doesn't value highly enough your excellent time and talents. Okay. This one could use a little more drop shadow, huh? The arrow needs a drop shadow as well. Although I think I may fill the whole back in black. Those drop shadows will be useless. But I haven't decided that yet. Today's cartoon is a quickie compared to most of my other cartoons. Go. Give that some drop shadow as well. Cody, if you could get a few Texas papers to pay you $10 a cartoon. Tell him you'll draw 3 Texas cartoons a week and 2 national cartoons. You put their newspaper name in your cartoon. I think that's about the way you have to start cobbling together a little local list before you endeavor to do the syndication in the paper use stores. Paper use stores, if you're not in traditional syndication, I think is the best way to try to value your archive. Sorry, folks, it looks like Twitch is broken chat today. They're unable to connect to chat. If you want to chat with me, you can go over to YouTube, or you can go to Cagle.com. On the front page of Cagle.com, you'll see a pop-up window that's got my current stream. Probably the easiest way to find me. Oh, no, but that takes you to the Twitch feed. Ah, and then you're stuck with no chat again. Yeah, you gotta go to YouTube if you want to chat. Because Twitch is not working. So, YouTube is... just go search for Daryl Cagle in YouTube. Oh, if you go to my Facebook page, facebook.com/politicalcartoons, you see the link in my most recent post that goes to the YouTube page. That makes it easy to find. And then you can chat. To figure out what I'm going to do with the background on this, make things pop a little more clearly. Okay, that one's going to have, I drew that arrow there. Maybe it goes like that. And on top of the toe, so it's a little more clear that it really is pointing at this toe. Cody says chat's working fine in YouTube on his iPhone. Good. This is good. Cody, I think you're the only person here who's chatting. If you have any more questions, here I am. People like to complain that I'm not responsive enough to emails, and I am not responsive enough to emails, but when I'm sitting here drawing this, I'm pretty responsive. I think you lose some of the detail with the tiny picture on the iPhone, because I'm doing this in nice big HD. And you should get some pretty clear view of my line art. This is also going to be a quick, easy one to color, so I probably won't make a video of that. That would be not a lot of time and not a lot of information conveyed, I think. Okay, now down here, that 4-H looks nice and dark on the vellum. It does. Did you have that result when you did your test using my process, Cody? Also, I've tried different vellums, and the kind I like the most is Duraline from a company called Seth Cole, and I find that it is in most major art stores, not in little ones like Michael's, but in any serious art store you should see Duraline from Seth Cole, and you can buy it online. I think it's great. I like the tooth to it. I like the Regina Freeland writes, glad I saw this on Twitter. Love your cartoons and your site. Well, thank you very much, Regina. Cody writes, I'm casting your YouTube vid live on my 50-inch TV using Chromecast. Nice and big. Is it looking good at 50 inches with my my HD 1080 wide? I hope it is. Okay. That is an asterisk for a little bit of text in the corner, which is going to read, there are six more little piggies who didn't score well enough in the polls for this to be featured in this cartoon. We will put them in another cartoon that no one sees. That's just too wordy to write. Not quite as dark for me. I tried Bien Fang. Looks fabulous. Bien Fang looks fabulous? Well, good. One thing I like about this paper is the plasticness of it. It doesn't look like it's plastic, but it is just absolutely plastic. And it's very sturdy, and it lasts forever. And you can get it wet, and it doesn't matter. And I think that's pretty cool. All right. We place the box. Okay, there's that side. John Waters Jr. Hi, I'm here now. I was watching on Cagle.com. Well, nice to see you, John. Yeah, Cagle.com has the Twitch feed on it, and Twitch's chat is just not working. So you have my apologies for that. Twitch has this creative community. Go to Twitch Creative. And it's really pretty nice. I like the idea of looking in on people as they're doing their process and not noticing many top cartoonist there, or no editorial cartoonist there but me. But it only started in October, and it is quite quite an endeavor to make yourself draw live like this. I think it would scare lots of cartoonists. It is kind of scary. You want to get up and go to the bathroom. You want to make your mistakes and not have people know you made those mistakes. It's kind of scary. But I like it. You know, if I get this going efficiently, then I've got another thing, the videos, that isn't really costing me any time because I have to spend this time doing the drawings anyway. The newspapers are so frantic to have video content and make the cartoonists into bloggers, make them do other stuff. I think most cartoonists would be pretty resistant to the idea of doing this. They're already so overworked. But I think it's pretty cool. I think it's better than a blog to have a live feed. Blogs are getting a little bit old. So I'm doing some crosshatch to try to give it a little volume. Cody Ford writes, in the old days, we would ask, what nib do you use? Hat ink? What paper? Now we want to know scan settings and digital tools. Ah, the good old days. Yeah, I'm often asked what pen you use. I say I draw in pencil. They want to know what pencil you use. And then when I tell them I use a hard pencil, that's dissatisfying to people because people don't want to draw with hard pencil. They want to draw with a soft pencil. They want to draw with a forgiving pen that lets them okay. Anyway, my answer, what kind of pencil I use, is not a very satisfying answer, I think, to most people. And they often seemed kind of shocked to hear that... oh, here's my son. Hello! Son's asking for the car keys. Bring them back. Need a little drop shadow too. Yeah, I've drawn this little piggy cartoon years ago. I think it was about the Middle East. I was gonna look it up and show it along here, but I didn't quite get to that. But easy to look it up in the archives if you are so interested, and it will have nothing to do with this. I think it was about Israelis and Palestinians. This one, I think, is probably a little better suited to little piggies. So, John, nice to know that that's working on Cagle.com. As you can quite imagine, when I'm here streaming, I'm not really able to check all that stuff during the time that I'm streaming. What you want to do with all this cross-hatching is have a little bit of curve that you can define the three-dimensionality of the curved surfaces you're drawing. All too often, beginning cartoonists have cross-hatching that doesn't relate to anything. It's just the way they want to move their pencil, which is ridiculous. Don't want to do that. Your cross-hatching is about the drawing, not about the way you want to move your hand. That's not the best looking toe. I may come back to that and move the arrow a little bit. I'm presuming at least people who follow the news a little bit will be able to discern who each toe is. John Waters writes, I arrived a little late. Will an archive be available for viewing a second time? Yes, it takes a little while for the archive to appear on YouTube. Because YouTube wants to process the video for about an hour. But give it time. It'll show up on YouTube. I'll post it in DarylCagle.com and I'll link it on Facebook. You could, there's a function in here for going back to the beginning of the video while I'm live streaming, but that's not too good for chat. Yeah, this Sarah was bothering me. John Waters writes, it was nice. I really appreciate your site, so getting the opportunity to watch is exciting. Ah, very good. Thank you, John. Okay. That toenail is not in the right spot, is it? Toenails can be in funky places. But they have to be in funky places that are descriptive of the toe. How does that look? Is that better? I'm not sure it is. That another shot. I make lots of mistakes and I do lots of erasing. One reason I like the pencil and the vellum, it is very forgiving. Very forgiving of mistakes. think that's looking a little more right. So you need a little more pad to the toe on this side. I'll give that a little crosshatch that way. A little bit of sense of knuckle going on. There, I think that's a little better. Okay, big toe. Could make the toenail shoot out past the top of the toe. Not sure how untrimmed Trump should be. My buddy Taylor Jones would say, put this haircut on top of the toe. Taylor drew a cartoon of Trump with his penis sticking out of his pants, and the penis has the same haircut. And as funny as that was, you can look it up on politicalcartoons.com, as funny as it was, that's just trouble for us. Because editors will get mad, and then the middle school teachers will say, this site is not safe for my classroom. Editors who would never print the cartoon will call or write to say, I'm offended by this. You should not have these cartoons. You must take this down right away. And I guess toenail's still too big. I'm going to shorten it on this end. I don't put a whole lot of thought into toenails. John Waters writes, I've been a newspaper managing editor since 1993 and have worked with several local community artists. This is really fun. Oh, well, excellent. So you're still a newspaper managing editor, John? Does your paper subscribe to Cagle Cartoons? Galveston? I should know that off the top of my head. My apologies. Do I like that toenail? I don't know. Maybe I'll just think about it a little bit more and go on to the next thing. That's what you do when you start overworking and overfutzing on something. You step away, work on something else for a while. And like I said, this cartoon is a quickie. Most cartoons are much more trouble than this. Not doing any caricatures or anything here. Just generic toes. Well, I guess these are presidential campaign toes, huh? But yeah, this Twitch community, I like the Twitch community. I like the idea of having a window on artists' process and watching their desktop all day long. Some of these guys don't say much at all. Some of them just do their bedazzling or their not too impressive stuff, and sometimes they don't talk very much and whatever. Ones I don't like are the ones that play music. People tell me, you should play music. You don't have to worry about talking so much. Well, I don't want to listen to somebody else's music. I'm not going to make them listen to my music. It's probably looking okay. Okay, enough. Okay. Yeah, Twitch chat is still down. Sorry about that, folks. I've learned that I can't talk while I let her. My brain just doesn't want to allow that. Cartooning is a negative art, and I never have anything good to say about anybody. But I do tend to lay off of things that I am not vehemently opposed to, and I find that I'm kind of in an odd, strange cartooning minority in not minding Donald Trump so much. I haven't been too hard on Donald Trump. This little piggy is huge, and the holes. So Donald Trump is the big toe, and he's not treated too badly in this cartoon. He's the big toe. So my apologies to you folks watching on Twitch. Sorry that the chat isn't working. And again, if you'd like to please subscribe, because I'd like to see if I can get a little community going, and I would appreciate your subscribing, both on YouTube and on Twitch. And please, if you want to chat, you can move from Cagle.com, which is where you're probably watching it, over to search Daryl Cagle on YouTube, or go to my Facebook page, facebook.com/politicalcartoons. And you'll have links to the YouTube page for the live stream on YouTube, where the chat does work. This box isn't looking too square. I may want to square it up in Photoshop, or I may be satisfied with it not being square. I have to take another look. I'll certainly move the lettering around a little bit in Photoshop to clean this up. My apologies for my head being too big, too. I didn't leave quite enough time to do my camera settings and prepping for this. The camera just wants to give me a big head. Okay. Now I've got to do a bunch of stuff in here to give it a little more character. I think I'm going to put some crosshatch behind it. Am I? John Waters writes, "No, I'm not with the paper anymore. I left 2 years ago regarding health issues. At the time, we had a local illustrator, and our features section included cartoons we picked up from our big city partner." Your big head is fine. Oh, good, good. Well, sorry about the health issues. Yeah, it needs some junk going on in the background. Oh, in case you're wondering, over here I have a piece of sandpaper that I scratched the pencil on to get a chisel point. I reach over every so often, you hear scritchy scratch. Oh, Nadim, nice to see you here again. Do you draw the first idea that goes into your mind for a cartoon, or are there some twists and alternatives you explore? I have lots of bad ideas that don't quite make it to the drawing board. So, no, I'm pretty far from drawing the first idea. And for a cartoon like this, I work a lot of it out on the drawing board as I'm going along. This one is more writing than art, I think. Which, in general, I think is not what I like to do, but gotta mix them up. So I'm gonna put some tone in this. That's going to make all of this crosshatch not look quite so difficult to sort through. With the tone in here, it's going to be pretty easy to read. But I don't want the tone to be flat. I want to have lots of stuff going on in it, which is why I'm doing this crosshatch in here. I learned some time ago that what people want from me is they want to see me draw something. They want to see my handwork, and they don't want to see effects in Photoshop. They want Photoshop to just be in support of what my hand does. So I'm not going to go back there and do fancy blends and effects and things in the background. I'm just going to put some color through my stuff that comes out of my hand and keep the lines clean and crisp. Nadim writes, thank you very much. Always a pleasure and an honor to see you working. Very inspiring. Oh, the kind words. I love the kind words. One thing that I kind of do is a little cheat is I'll come back a lot on a lot of my lines and give them a little thicker end, which really deceives people into thinking that I'm using a pen. And I kind of like the look of the lines looking like they've gone thick to thin. Sometimes people will say, what kind of pen do you use? And I say, oh, I don't use a pen, I use a pencil. And they're so disappointed because they really wanted to go out and buy a pen. But I think most people think of drawing with pencil in a different way than I do, because I draw pretty hard, where I expect every line I put down to be black all the way through and to show up in the drawing. I don't do lots of light little futzing around like lots of people do with pencil. One thing I thought of and discarded right at the beginning of this was making the boxes black and reversing the lettering out of the boxes. I like the look of that sometimes. Sometimes I'll do speech balloons that are black with reverse type in the black speech balloon. And sometimes I get complaints about that because there's always an editor who wants to print a cartoon too small and they have lousy printing and they don't print it like line art. They put a half tone on it, and so those little white lines in the lettering want to fill. And then the editor says, hey, I can't print your cartoon with these dark areas. And I say, don't put a half tone screen on it. Don't print it so small. And that's not what they want to hear. John, I don't think you mentioned whether Galveston subscribes to Cagle Cartoons. You see my papers, my cartoons in your local paper? This is looking good and lots of crosshatchy. So I'll put a background color in there and all the crosshatch on there should look pretty nice. Whereas if I hadn't put it there and I just had a flat background color, kind of boring. I was going to reverse this out. Now I'm thinking I won't. I'm going to leave a spot for there and not reverse it. Because I've gone a different direction with the background than blacking it in, as I was thinking I was going to do in the first place. Oh, I do have a comment on Twitch. Waygood Ben writes, have you ever done any witness cartoon work to find any criminals. Oh, you mean an artist in a police department would draw a suspect from a description? No, I haven't done that. My cartoonist daughter, Susie, sometimes does work as a courtroom artist. She's very good. And I think that would be some fun to do sometime, cover some high-profile trial. Way good, Ben. You're my only comment to come through Twitch. Nice to see you there. John Waters, you're in San Francisco, North Bay. You don't recall whether the Galveston paper uses my cartoons. Well, I guess that's kind of an obscure thing to recall. So, San Francisco, you don't have to worry about hurricanes anymore. Just have to worry about paying the rent. In San Francisco, in the Bay Area, our cartoons run in the Digital First Media Group papers. That's the San Jose Mercury News and Oakland Tribune, the East Bay stuff, Contra Costa, the stuff that circles around San Francisco. We're also in the Examiner, but we're not in the Chronicle. Oh, Cordy's the one who's in Galveston. I'm sorry. I'm getting all confused. So, Cody, do you you see my cartoons in the paper in Galveston? I'm getting close to being finished here since I'm going to fill this with type. Actually, you know, I should fill it with crosshatch because I don't know how big the type's going to be. And if I don't do that, I'm going to be left with a blank spot with no type and no crosshatch, and it's going to look like garbage. Better just to have it there and then white it out, huh? So let's do that. So, hey, my apologies for mixing you guys up. If I can get this going well, I'm thinking maybe I want to start a Cagle Cartoons channel and try to encourage some of my other guys to do this, give them a little hand-holding to help them get into the streaming, because I think it is a very difficult transition. It was hard for me to figure out the tech stuff, and I still, as you can see, haven't quite got it figured out with my big head. It takes me too long to get everything working. I need to have a better checklist. John Waters writes, we were Lee Enterprise Publications, formerly Pulitzer. Ah, we have a lot of Lee newspapers that subscribe to Cagle Cartoons. As a chain, they are a friendly to us chain, so we like the Lee Enterprises. They are a bit notorious for firing the staff cartoonists, but that, unfortunately, is not much of a distinction anymore, as so many papers are terrible about that. All right. Getting close to being finished here. This one has only taken an hour and 16 minutes. I had one the other day that John Waters writes, yes! Oh, about my review of Lee Enterprises. Lee Enterprises is a huge group and they account for a lot of our papers. Okay. That looking right? I can do a bunch with color, so I shouldn't, and with grayscale, so I shouldn't ruminate too much. I should just get this done. Regina writes, papers in Phoenix, the Arizona Republic, East Valley Tribune, etc. I've seen Steve Benson's work on your site with other Phoenix, Arizona cartoonists. Yeah, we're not in the Arizona Republic, though. Trying to get in there for years, but they're resistant. We're in a lot of Gannett papers. Gannett is another friendly to us group and accounts for probably 40 of our papers. Oh no, more than that. Maybe 60. PoliticalCartoons.com, DarylCagle.com. I may stretch some of these around so that they're just a little more correctly placed. But it's going to be the color and the grayscale that makes the composition on this pop a little better. A little bit helpful looking at this on the screen too, because it gives me another perspective, kind of like standing up and walking across the room. Get a different view on it. You have some hair on the foot. I've got some white space here. If I don't like the hair on the foot, easy enough to take out. Let's give it a try. Give him a little hairy top of the foot. Hairy foot. What do you guys think? Hairy foot good? Or should the foot not be hairy? So, yeah, both Gannett and Lee Enterprises let each editor pick what cartoons they want. And so you cannot sell to the whole group. They're respectful of their editor's proclivities, which is nice because typically when they let a whole group choose a service and impose it on the editors, the other syndicates come in and undersell us and we lose the group. That's happened two or three times. Oh, Cody Ford says Harry. John Waters gives two thumbs up to Harry. One toe with a corn, urges Cody. I put a lot of these little round disturbing hair things in here. Disturbing things. I think if I did a corn, it would be a little too much to try to graphically explain. John writes, I worked for Gannett too in Palm Springs. I rather like Gannett. You know, I live half the time in Nashville, Tennessee, where we have a big flagship Gannett paper, and we've got like 20 papers in Tennessee, and Tennessee is very Gannett heavy. The Memphis Commercial Appeal is Gannett. There's a bunch of these suburban little weeklies all through Tennessee that are Gannett. One problem with Gannett is that they have broken up their art department into three large regional centers that serve all of the newspaper, all the Gannett papers. And since all of the Gannett papers do not subscribe to our service, all this great art that could be used for illustration in other parts of the paper is completely just ignored because it's dealt with by these regional art departments that are not editorial cartoon savvy and haven't been able to break through that barrier with them. It's difficult and not very efficient, I think, on Gannett's part. Oh, in a bid for efficiency, I think they end up with something that's not efficient, not giving them as good use as they could get of their Cagle cartoon subscription. Okay, I'm going to fiddle around with lettering here a little bit in Photoshop. I may pull it back a little bit and size it a little better for each of these blocks. This one needs to come up just a little bit at the top and pull a little bit away from that left side. But aside from that, I think it's looking pretty pretty crosshatchy, and a little bit of light color will break it up, and it's looking good. So thank you much, everybody. I think I'm just about done. So That is that. You've seen it here. This is today's cartoon. I will color it up tomorrow. Probably go out tomorrow afternoon. And So, that's it. Thank you all very much. And please keep an eye out for my announcement of when I will be drawing the next cartoon. I think I'm not going to color this one in a live stream because the coloring's not going to be too interesting. But you saw it here. And John, Regina, Cody, thank you all for stopping by. Tell your friends, please subscribe and like my stuff. And I appreciate the subscriptions. And thank you all so much. Off I go. See you next time.